Regarding the, although it appears that it's not currently an issue, we know at one time there was talk about changing the makeup or existence of the planning commission based on financial aspects of the planning commission. And the best way to talk to you about how we can save money, I think, is just in the last 5 minutes, I ran through the report I gave the board on where we're spending money and flagged ones that we might be able to talk about changes potentially. The first time is when our, the first issue is when our meetings begin. Right now we begin them all at 6:30. Historically, we've always felt that was the most appropriate time. We've had some members who worked the traditional 8:30 to 5 job in Alpharetta or downtown or anyplace else, and 6:30 was as soon as they could get here. But just from a technical answer, especially our hearing night, we have two people from planning, water and sewer, engineering, two people filming, building maintenance. We've got 7 or 8 staff people at the meeting. If your meetings started closer to 5 o'clock, there's some savings there when staff people aren't spending as much time in between our normal work day and when the meeting starts. Possibility. Second possibility, I would say, would be thinking about more long-term, who are we going to have attending our meetings. We've had maybe 3 or 4 months now, we've had legal staff at our meetings. I think there's two issues there. One, we have to decide long term. Over the long term, we need to decide, do we want to continue that? Do we want them at our meetings or not? If we do have them at our meetings, in particular the work sessions, one of the things I'd suggest we think about is trying to limit some of our contact with Ken and his staff and save it for that work session. And it doesn't sound like a big deal at first because you figure, well, if I'm talking to him on Wednesday or if I'm talking to him on Tuesday night, what's the difference? And in my mind, the difference is if you have an issue that, say, Pam, you brought up recently about looking at detention ponds. Say, I don't see a legal tie to that, but say that was an issue you felt there was a legal question. If you call Ken up on a Wednesday and talk about it with him, you might talk about it for a while. If you bring it up at a work session and Ken's there, the other 4 members might say, you know what, we don't have any interest in talking about detention ponds, we really don't care about that, and it's done before it started. So there's some savings there by having a discussion in front of the group and letting the group monitor itself and decide what they see as a priority and what they know.
Should we not filter those questions through the director of planning before going to legal staff? Would that not help?
That's a possibility as well. Yeah. If you wanted to, you could propose that if you have legal questions, you run them through across my desk. And if it's something I'm comfortable answering.
If you, or if you have to go
not because
to
I'm giving
legal.
You legal advice, but yeah. Because I've already gotten the answer in the past.
Right. Or you could.
I can
go on to legal.
I can answer
and then
question.
As a
decide.
Third level, if persons were not satisfied, then they could go directly to legal.
They could go directly to legal, and I think they always have the option too of going back and talking to the board of commissioner that appointed you, whose district you represent, and saying, look, I have a question I think is a legal question. I feel like the planning director is ignoring me on it. Will you help me take this to the next level and help me get an answer on it? There's a few options.
Do you have a number of how much legal has cost in the last 6 months?
For these kind of issues?
Yes, for these kind of issues?
We have, I have 6 months of billing that I could print out and break down.
This versus maybe the previous, so we can kind of get a handle on, you know, if it's increased.
Well, I can tell you the last 6 months have absolutely increased from the standpoint that they're attending our meetings. I think it's
what about
informal. I don't think it's, I don't, I can't, I haven't quantified it, but I can tell you just my hunches, calls have generally increased to legal in the last 6 months as well. We've had a lot more calls to legal. It seems much more often than I'm talking with Ken over the course of the week and we are following up based on a call that he got from a planning commissioner, or that I had a call and the planning commissioner identified, their next stop was his office or calling him, and we're touching base on it. I think definitely in the last 6 months, we've seen more of that.
Personally, I think they should all be channeled via the director of planning. Then you know, have like a hierarchy, and then you either, if you can answer it satisfactorily, that's wonderful. Then we don't even have to get legal involved. If not, and you know you cannot answer that question, then you would go to legal. And then thirdly, if you cannot come back with a satisfactory answer, then yes, then I would say that, I would think that that would lessen the burden on the legal staff.
Okay, on that one, probably.
Do any of you have input on that?
If there was interest in that, then I'd like to talk to Ken about, does he see that as something being appropriate for our bylaws? Or does he think it's just more of a standing policy that how are we going to do our business day to day?
And how are we going to save money?
Yeah. Let me keep running through that list. We're getting into smaller stuff here on this one. But the books, if you see some information that we are consistently putting in your books month in, month out, that you don't think is helping you in making your decisions, you cut down on the copy cost by eliminating something, or having it about, or having the backup that, well, it's not in your books, but you know this is available on the website. That's pretty small stuff. But it is something we could cut down if we felt like there were documents in here.
Well, if we postpone one, the same information goes to the next month.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess...
Well, and I would be okay with it coming in the form of a PDF, you know, to where you can pull it open anywhere. You know,
I just don't know if I
could
print that multitude.
The word we've had in the past is what happens meeting night. And our people in the past have felt knowing they have the product in their hands and then feeling obligated, they almost have to.
But if we, at the end of the meeting, it was announced, we have ZA or whatever, this, this, and this, a list of those that are going to be seen again next month, keep your book.
Well, a perfect example is the public participation information. I put that in there.
We don't need it.
See, I could leave that out and save a lot.
Yeah.
Because it's every time.
Yeah, we don't need a copy of
it. If we, with an example like that, we could just put one sheet right inside the cover just as a kind of a reminder to say, this is the kind of information that's on these status, not in the books.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're ever looking for it,
you
know, you got it at home, mm-hmm. but you know from experience, it's not the kind of thing you need public hearing about. It's the kind of thing you want at home when you're doing the research, and not something you need to put to meetings. So maybe, I don't know, long-term you go toward identifying like, things like that and saying, this is great for home research, I can get it online, if I don't need it.
Yeah, and I think like the public participation, because a lot of those names are on all of them, because they're on everything. A lot of the notifications.
Delivery of the Planning Commission books. I believe right now we're still delivering them as an independent trip to.
Greg delivers them as he's on his, when he's out and about, right?
You know, if people knew they were in town, if they were here for other meetings and wanted to pick them up, coordinating with us. Little stuff again. Not that big of a change, but if you could pick up your books, if you knew you were going to be around, that's something that would reduce some time. I think maybe more significant one is keeping our eye on this meeting and on months where we don't think there's a need for the meeting. Let's call off the meeting. And that's maybe one of the biggest savers. Having this meeting alone is going to have $700-$800 from it for this meeting like this. So
don't have a workshop if not needed.
Yeah. If there's either nothing on the agenda, that's an easy one. Or maybe more likely one is we've got some of this housekeeping type stuff on the agenda and only one HOP. Maybe we say, you know what? I feel comfortable enough that one HOP would know it inside and out, and this, you know, something about our bylaws can wait a month. So I'll hold a couple things down there. It's one of them we don't really talk about, the other one we talk about a month from now. So being on the lookout for that is the last thing I could scratch up that was a possibility of saving some money.
I'm just saving money. Don't write me a check for one. I have to pay. You have a quorum, so good meeting.
So Matt?
Are you okay with most of the things that have been discussed?
I am. I think reducing that. So that's the one thing that has been my issue is the redundancy of things. And everybody that's been mailed in this group, that should, I mean, we don't need that. I mean, we need the plat.
Technical review.
Technical review, the staff,
the
recommendation would be engineering. You might just put a letter, a copy of the letter that was sent out to the people, but not everybody that it was sent to.
And you always know that, I mean, you can call me anytime and I'm going to file with you. If you look on any status, if you have a question, you can call me.
Would you be okay with moving the time up earlier?
Yeah, I'm fine now. It doesn't matter now. I'm going to do it 8 o'clock in the morning.
And so you, it's going to be more of an issue either you're in town or you're not in town. So you'll either be here or you won't be here.
And
how about you? Is it an issue?
It's tougher, but for moving the actual section, which really will reduce costs, I don't see a problem with that.
The most important thing is my kids' baseball softball game.
Mm-hmm.
If it was earlier.
Earlier, you can get there,
earlier,
because there's 7 o'clock. Yeah.
Yeah, good.
Thank you.
Right.
I'm in.
So I'm okay with moving the regular session, but if we can keep the work session, that would make it where I only have to leave downtown.
Well, what were you talking about? Work session, or were you talking about both?
Both are possibilities. Mm-hmm. The hearing night, we've got a much larger staff here at the hearing night, and there's more savings in moving that meeting.
And I would say that, at the very least, could be moved to 6 o'clock, because we used to always be here at 6 o'clock anyway, at the very least.
The only thing that I would caveat on this is whether it impacts the ability of the public to be there. That's the counterbalance that you do have to consider, is there are a lot of people who work downtown, and you know, to the extent that it jumps to like 5, it becomes a real difficult thing for them to get here as opposed to 6:30.
But for most, it's that 1 or 2 a year issue that they're coming for, that it's a special situation that I would think that they would get off work to come for those.
We've thought about that same thing. We've talked about it in years past. There's pros and cons to it. And one thing that's come up is that, well, the commissioners meet, they start at 5 o'clock. So if we want to start at 6, 5:30 or whatever it was, it seems to be working for them.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't seem to be concerned about it.
Well, they do 2 o'clock sessions.
So with that, you know, shift that one to 5 o'clock now if you need. Because that would truly reduce it.
All right, so on item 1, the start of the meetings, first thing I say is all this stuff, what I would like to do is hear from the Planning Commission about what it is you'd like to do. And then let me come back. Let's not implement something tonight. But let me come back next month and say, okay, here's
maybe have an outline.
Here's the plan to put this in place. Here's the outline of what we talked about. Are we still all comfortable with it? And then let's put it in place.
Well, and I'd like you to go back and look and see, does this really save us money?
And all the little things. Notice our yearly calendar. All that stuff. We're talking about changing meeting times. Let's make sure we got enough time to implement it and to do it seamlessly. So what I'm hearing is on meeting start time, the public hearing, I'm thinking about shifting the time of that to 6 o'clock.
I think you can even go 5 if you want.
I don't see exactly that's
5 o'clock, I think.
I mean, 5 o'clock, if you're going to do six.
The Board of Commissioners meet at 5 o'clock, and I know people have talked about it over the years, but if they have to be here, they will get here.
If you're going to try to save money, you got to close that window.
Because there's still the hours that, they're here.
Shifting by 30 minutes really doesn't do much. Shifting it by an hour and a half.
It's a problem for students.
It gets them out that much earlier.
Yeah.
Teresa brought up a good point. Let me, in that month, between now and next month, one of the things to talk to is, we'll talk to the board and make sure they've had, it hasn't come up in the last couple of months, but they've had a history of
not being able to get into our meetings.
The same night as our meeting, the same afternoon as our meetings.
Well, see, it's five or six. See what would work the best with them. I think we're open.
And make the point of, you know, how much we're looking at saving, see if they can make it work.
Okay. Any proposal on the work session, or just stay 6:30 in that?
If we could keep it at 6:30, that means I only have to come up early one time.
So no change there.
6:30 or 6?
Could you do 6? That's what we used to always.
It's always trying to escape downtown.
So it's like it's a juggling act.
Yeah. 6:30 is...
is a lot better.
A lot safer.
Okay. We want you to give your one piece, Jim.
Yeah, no joke.
I'm regarding our legal staff attending meetings and contacting the legal staff. Recommendation there?
I like the idea of funneling it through.
All through the director. I think that's what we should do. Yeah. If it needs to be put in the bylaws, so be it. But I think that needs to be. Because you need to know any issues anyway, unless it's about you, and you know they'll go to their own commissioner about that.
Well, and ultimately, that's the default mechanism, is go through your commissioner.
Your commissioner.
Do you think that sometimes people don't realize that when they pick the phone up and they call Ken that they're being charged? Do they think it's just part of...
I'm not a good trying to guess what people think.
I mean, that's what I'm wondering
I
is happening.
I think it takes a lot of calls and they don't show up on the bill. I'll say that.
Yeah.
I think if every call he took and the planning commission showed up on the bill, it'd be bigger than it is. Significantly. Okay, let me look into making a recommendation on that.
Well, I think the legal staff only needs to be at the work session whenever you deem we need them here.
Okay, I'll tell you right now, I feel like we're still using them a lot right now. We're talking about changes to our bylaws, talking about a lot of new stuff, so I'm going to have them here for a while.
And ask him what he thinks about that also.
Yeah, I'm going to have them here at least for another quarter before I even get into thinking.
Well, and we can, do what we need him for in the very beginning, and then he can leave.
Right.
Like we've been
like
doing
today.
Last few times we did that.
On the books, I heard before, maybe the recipient list for public participation notification is one thing that we don't need.
No, because I mean we don't.
I put
you
the plan
all,
and
yeah.
the report in there now. So really, all you looking for is just the letter sent to the people, and that would be it. That you could see that the letter was sent.
The letter, the flats. You know, that's.
I'm talking about just the public participation.
Yes, that's
just
it.
The public participation letter.
If the letter
all you
was
really
sent.
Are
yes.
concerned. Okay.
Well, let's that one. Definitely, if anything would change, that one's probably the easiest. It's just very informal. There's definitely no rules we need for that. So, Teresa and I will take a first look at it for next month's meeting. And then we'll just try to bring it up once in a while in the future to say, how are the books looking? Are you getting enough information? Are you getting too much information? Are you finding what you need on the website when you need it? And we'll just have an ongoing
session. Well, I don't think from month to month we need to have a new book with any of the duplicate information. If it's been postponed, we should save our book from this month for whatever zone.
I think that
and just give us any new information.
Back in the day, we'd have applications. You'd have to bring 15 books to the meeting because we had things that were postponed
and
for
actually,
2 or 3 years.
And actually, you could go to a binder, a 3-ring binder, and we could just out. and just add what we do need. You wouldn't even have to bind it like that. We could have it in a,
in an envelope. Starting that this month?
Loose.
Next week, we remind you to hold on to these purple books, and in October, we don't, if information hasn't changed, we don't,
just give us new information that we need to have. Is that all right with everyone?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's fine.
And I like your idea of moving to the three-ring binder system.
Yeah, you can take out what we don't
we
need, and then we just...
We drop the binder off, and then it comes back.
That is a
full
cost.
Yeah.
Yes, this has got to be a cost
and
every month.
And a time cost every month, to, even though it's a machine that you use, but still.
Yeah.
The supplies are
so just one of the, you know, big three-inch binders that it would...
Pick up books, that's pretty minimal, but if you happen to know you're going to be in town, call Teresa.
What is a good date? I mean, when should we call? That's what I can't
I'm
ever,
always getting ready at
yeah, I never know.
What if you just start blasting out an email and you say,
books
are done today and Greg plans to deliver them on Wednesday. And if someone knows they're going to be there,
and
you know, between
back,
that day and Wednesday,
hold
mine, I'll be there.
It usually goes in correspondence with the signs. Within a day or two, he tries to deliver the books when the signs go up, because I know that's usually when you're going to get phone calls, is when the signs go up. So it's, you know.
Give me just a second, catch up. Okay. Canceling the Planning Commission work session, I don't think there's anything we have to decide on, just something we keep... keep an eye on if you think there's
well, I think we've done it on a few occasions.
We've
in the
canceled
last, yeah.
Even our hearing when we had no,
exactly, when we didn't have it. I think we definitely need to do that. And maybe even more often if there's, you know, nothing real pertinent.
The work session's probably easier, but the hearing, if there's nothing on the agenda, that's a simple one, too.
Okay.
That's what I can identify as some easy items.
That's good. I, you know, that's this is some of the housekeeping I wanted to get done.
Okay. So let us. There's a couple of those that we'll just start doing, and then a couple other ones that we'll come back and recommend.
And we don't need a motion for that, do we?
No, because we're not going to do anything. I'm going to come back next month and give you a more detailed breakdown of what we need to do.
Okay. And maybe if you get something together before the meeting, if you could email.
Yeah.
Everybody can kind of look, since Jimmy's out of town, he'll be back in, I think. And this hopefully won't be a surprise. I mean,
yeah.
I think this is just housekeeping.
Yeah.
I'll do it.